أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين. All praise is due to Allah, Lord of the worlds. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created us so that we should worship Him and serve Him.
Content over everything.
And to have Tawheed in Him, and as well to establish His deen. All praise is due to Almighty Allah, who has guided us. For if we were not guided, we wouldn't have been guided. Who has guided us to the truth and made clear what is true and what is falsehood. So today we will have a short address by special guest, inshallah. And I hope you enjoy it. And pay attention, sit back, learn and reflect. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you tawfiq. Okay. All right. Bismillah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين. By the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent. I take refuge from Satan. Today I'm gonna have little small message for Ali Dara. The one he called himself Dawa. I don't know where he borrowed this name from. Last week I saw a small video when Jedi talking to him about one verse in Quran. And he telling him, this is not in the book, this is not in Quran. guys, please, not anybody call himself Dawa or Imam or Sheikh is Imam or Sheikh. You have to check before you buy. Ali Dara is a clown. I don't know. And he's a thief as well, because When you steal a name, like if you are a donkey and you call yourself a doctor, it doesn't work. Ali Dara is at least he's son of double muta. And this message to Jedi. Jedi, you cannot understand Quran. You will never understand Quran when you have a filth heart. You have to be looking for guidance to understand the Quran. And you have to understand the language. I'm not telling you to be Arab. Because if you speak Arabic, you are not Arab. You're gonna be Jedi who is Nigerian, speak English and speak Arabic. If you don't know the language and the eloquence of the language, you cannot challenge Quran. The verse talking about brains and heads. When your head bleeds, it bleeds intellect. It bleeds comprehension. Because I think you know that the more you drink alcohol, the more you lose your head. The more you drink alcohol and the more you take drugs, the more you lose your head. So the verse saying, when they have wine from Jannah, from paradise, they don't have headache. And their brain doesn't get bleeding. Bleeding of knowledge. Bleeding of comprehension. Haven't you seen anybody drunk talking to a lamppost? Or talking to the bus station, bus stop? Why do you do that? Because Allah the Almighty gave them brain. And because they are stupid, they've been intoxicated and lost their brain. And becoming less than animal, because I never seen animal talking to a bus stop or lamppost. But I saw so many. Anyway, if you want to understand, you are not a position to challenge Quran. You are not. You are far away from challenging Quran. But have some humbleness, man. When you don't understand something, don't be arrogant and say this is wrong. Instead of saying how this is comes, how is this verse coming like that? Because in Quran, in Arabic, when you talk something, it depends on the proverb. What is this word relating to? That's it for you today. And quick reminder about Jamal. Jamal doesn't represent Islam. And I don't like what he did. I know COE and brother DJ, they have a good heart and trying to help him. But brother, be wise, man. You should be wise where you put your money. Jamal is enjoying living in Britain, and he have an iPhone, and he's smoking, and he taking selfie with XYZ. There's a lot of people desperate for your money. There's a lot of people in the heart of Africa. They have no clean water. They're dying. 300,000 people dying in Africa from dirty water. 1 million person dying from AIDS. How many people dying from medication? So when I got nothing against those people who contribute. But before you give help, check who's you're giving help to. And you should have your own miskin. You should have your own needy. If you don't know them, ask your mother back home, ask your parent, ask your auntie. You should have people who are really desperate for this help. Look what he did. He accused everybody helping him. They are crooks and thieves. Can you imagine this human? When someone asked him about Sisi, he said, everybody, anybody doesn't love Sisi, he's a donkey, son of a donkey. Who's the son of a donkey? Sisi killing 4,500 people in one day. Last 2 weeks, he killed 91. He executed them. And this shows the mentality. If you are political refugee, political against who? You are not playing against the system. You are not with the system. You are not Islamist. And you're crying like a fat baby. And after that, you he came to DJ in his channel. He told them, record me. And he blaming people, oh, you disclosed me. He won't take the money in quiet. I wish, brother, I wish COE doesn't give him the money. I wish he channeled this money to any people deserve it. And I believe the most people who are desperate for money are people of the Sub-Saharan or Central Africa. Even these people have loads of resources, but unfortunately they're having a tough life. And Ali Dara is ignorant. Look what he said, a verse in Quran, a man, he's supposed to be Ali Dawah, Ali propagation of Islam, and he said the verse is not in Quran. Why? Because he's ignorant. Because he's son of Gabal Muta. And the way he's showing off about this cadet guy, the one who rapper or whatever, the guy, he used anything to promote his media whore. He can sell himself, his family, to get few clicks. Just he want to get money and he get famous. Shouldn't he study Quran before he come to Dawah? Shouldn't he know a verse in Quran? Is it in Quran or not Quran? Shouldn't he in his bloody iPad look it up before he say it's not in Quran? Ali Dara doesn't represent Islam. Ali Dara is a media whore. Jamal is only shut up you donkey, shut up you Obama, and that's it. You get nothing out of him like except that. Please guys, whoever done contribute to help the needy, help the desperate first. Help the desperate, and then check if someone come. Look at people, man, in Kashmir. Look at people in Bangladesh. Is that the fact? Why your money didn't flow to these people? Why? What makes him so special to bridge this money? And he's rude and clown. He accusing people who trying to help him being thief. Anyway, I'll make it short. Jedi, please, man, please. You are grown up, man. Stop being enemy to Islam. Try to comprehend the Quran. Try to comprehend verses. Instead of coming and you look very silly, honestly. Wait for me, inshallah. I'll come and we'll have a chat on the speaker corner soon. May Allah guide the COE and bless the DJ and bless all the Muslim brothers.
Amen.
And assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. Jazakallahu khairan. So that was a short message by the special guest to address certain issues and events that have happened recently in the park, and to clarify and give his input into it. So this is another Sunday, and once again, you know, the Muslims are gathered here as well, having debates and discussions to talk about Islam, and we will prevail by Allah's permission. The truth will prevail. We have the truth, and anything else is falsehood, and there's no doubt about that. You see, Islam is the only deen that Allah will accept, and it will prevail by Allah's permission, you know. And the end result will be for those who have taqwa, وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The outcome will be in their favor. They will be the successful ones. They will be the inheritors. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and aid us and keep us steadfast in these testing times and trials, where this ummah is being tested and tried everywhere from various forms, from various angles. May Allah keep us firm and forgive us of our sins and our shortcomings, and have mercy upon us and guide us and keep us steadfast and firm. And may Allah make Islam triumphant everywhere. And those who are seeking guidance, may Allah guide you to the truth, to Islam, and to show you the criteria between truth and falsehood, the path which is clear. وَهَجَنَّاهُ النَّجَدَيْنِ. And we have shown you the two paths. إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. Either you be grateful or you be ungrateful. These are the two paths that lead us to Allah, that lead us, that people take and embark in this world. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help and aid us and change our situations, the situation of this ummah, and rectify it and grant us victory over the disbelieving folk. All praise is due to Almighty Allah, Lord of the worlds. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina wa Nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.
Content over everything. From
man, say it straight. Man, don't listen to BBC. Man, don't listen to ITV.
Okay, so they believe that, I mean, obviously it's not me, I'm a guest. Yeah, yeah. But they believe that there is no gravity, there is density. The density is the thing, you know, because I'm denser than the air around me, when I jump, I come back down because I'm dense. Which doesn't really, you know, it explains how things attract each other. But, you know, the their definition of density is basically very similar to gravity. It's very, very similar because I told them,